So we've come back a long ways. Now, we're going forward. So let's count this thing down and have a good night. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
In the Big Sky Conference this season on the offensive side of things. And we start at the running back position, and Rex Prescott, the leading rusher in the Big Sky Conference this year. We saw this TD run done against Idaho State, but he's had a great year.
Oh, he really has. We did see this run. What a fine running attack they have, but he's a lot of the reason.
Prescott with 1,494 yards now, averaging 7 yards a carry, 12 touchdowns, almost 150 yards a game in a passing-oriented conference. He's also got good hands out of the backfield.
Not very big, but he does a lot of things for him. Here's a cutback here. What a fine run that is.
Amerson, the back a year ago, got the national awards. And when we go to quarterback, the leader in passing efficiency. He's not flashy, doesn't have the rifle arm, but boy, Harry Leuns gets it done.
He really has. You know, he's been a big reason, kind of the unsung hero of that Eastern offense. When they needed it, he got it for them.
His first start a couple years ago against Idaho State, he threw 5 interceptions in the game. He's thrown just 5 interceptions all season, 21 touchdowns, and completed 62% of his passes in leading the Eagles to a 10-1 season in the playoffs. And we've got co-wide receivers. Jeff Ogden has to be one of the guys you mentioned when you talk about a wide receiver. He leads the conference in yardage by a wide margin, better than 104 yards a game.
Great speed, good hands, very competitive receiver. Catches the ball well, going away, breaking to the outside, to the inside. Effort guy.
McCarthy tried to get away, loses the ball. That's picked up. Did he stay in bounds to Terrace? Can he go? Got a block. He just might. It'll be about a 48-yard return if he takes it in, but he gets hauled down from behind. Thunder!
time and then throws. That one's picked off. Greg Belzer with the interception, and he will score. Redshirt freshman from Chewelah, Washington.
Chewelah's Lance Ballou in motion, and they'll run it with Prescott off the right side. Big hole on the first play. Keeps his balance. He could go. Will they haul him down? Good pursuit in the secondary. He gets away from another one. One man to try to catch, and he is gone. First play, 85 yards. Touchdown, Rex Prescott.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Let's get ready to rumble!
Y'all ready for this?
Perrigo standing inside the 50. JJ gets some leg into this. Perrigo makes a good job to get back and take it at his own 47. Again, eludes Dwight Smiley as the first tackler before being wrapped up by Mike Gilligan at the Penguins 45.
But Greg Belzer absolutely leveled one of the Youngstown State guys.
Leons going for extra yardage this time, and they'll pick it up with Ogden. Beats the tackle of Bell again, and this one's going to go. Bell hangs his head. Leons to Ogden, 77 yards, and the 10th touchdown catch of the year for Jeff Ogden.
Way McCarthy, good rollout, finds his tight end McBride, who came back in, and he'll be tackled just short of the first down marker, and he might need to get checked again after that hit by Chris Scott.
First the hit here. Boy, that was a hit. That was a takedown.
Get warm with the people on the dance floor. Now who got the people for the flame? Who can take the way that I flex on a track? Conclusion rampage. Ricky Rick on point with the knock I stop for my left. That be rolling the mad joints. So put your hands in the air. Cause there's a party over here. So grab yourself a beer. And we can get our FIFA on. I'm with it, so let me put my big brown FIFA on. I'm coming with the disco, I can flip so. I'ma drop a solo tip. Something for the honeys in the crowd. Let me hear it, so I can turn the party out till tomorrow afternoon. Cause when I grips my stills, no one leaves the room. So tell me, can you feel the mass girls coming with the FIFA, FIFA, FIFA? We'll be right back.
big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing,
we will rock you.
A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it out.
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face. Big disgrace, somebody better put your bag into your place.
Another first down. Uh-oh, we got a rumbler down the left side and a first down over the 40-yard line. The linemen are ready to celebrate. Jim Buzzard carrying the ball. The senior from Centralia with positive rushing yardage says, Coach, don't bring McKenzie anymore when Prescott needs a breather. I'm ready to go.
Look at this play. You know, they're excited about this. And the reason to be, little reverse to the tackle, and he's a big old horse. Look at him trucking up the sideline. Drawing a lot of attention. The Eastern sideline is hilarious. They're just having a great time.
one bites the dust. Hey, hey, another one bites the dust. Hey.
Blue in motion, and they'll run it with Prescott off the right side. Big hole on the first play. Keeps his balance. He could go. Will they haul him down? Good pursuit in the secondary. He gets away from another one. One man to try to catch, and he is gone. First play, 85 yards. Touchdown, Rex Prescott.
It's unlikely Eastern's all-time leading rusher will be getting any first or second looks from NFL scouts. That's just the way it is when you're 5'7 and 170 pounds. That's why Prescott is a perfect fit for the Eagles in 1AA football, if it is coaches saw when he was a raw recruit.
It was pretty evident to us that Rex was going to be a good college football player because he had the same type of foot speed that some of our other tailbacks had used in the mid-80s. And we lacked that type of foot speed at tailback when we recruited him. Even though he is under 5'6", I mean, he's a very diminutive person. He has the heart of a lion. And he was willing to wait in the background until it was his turn to be our starting tailback. He played behind two very capable running backs last year, or 2 years ago, David Lewis and Joe Sewell. Sewell had produced 1,000 yards. And then again in 96, Sewell produced another 1,000 yards and was a very outstanding football player in his own right. Rex took advantage of the situation in 1997 to have an exceptional year, particularly because of the fact we kept him healthy through the 1st of November.
Oh, it's been tough, you know. Just got to spend a lot of time in the weight room and, you know, just get mentally tough for it, I guess. You know, a lot of guys try to knock me out because I'm not the biggest guy, but, you know, I just try to do my best and try to win. The speed of the players is just, you know, it's just phenomenal. I mean, you got linebackers, you know, just as fast as you, so you can't outrun everybody like in high school. You have to sort of follow the play, you know. I felt like midway through last season, I felt that I was ready to play. I felt that I had a good shot at being a starter here.
Rex isn't the only football player in his family that plays collegiately in the Northwest. His younger brother, Robert, is a flanker at Oregon State. They're doing something they've wanted to do for a long time.
Well, me and my brother, you know, when we were younger, we loved to, you know, play like the Bills versus the Cowboys and stuff like that. So we liked to play when we were like six and stuff. And we got into like Pop Warner for the Bering and Bearcats, and then gradually our interest grew. So we made it to high school. Now we're both playing in college, so it's been fun.
And off to Prescott. He's in for a touchdown.
While Rex may be the biggest reason why the Eagles have soared this season, he's the first to admit he's far from the only reason why the Eagles are just 3 wins away from a national championship.
You got Petey and Buzz and Lance and Kane and Scotty J. And those guys, I love them like brothers. They protect me out on the field and they make sure I don't get hurt. So I got to look out for them. I never dreamed of having this type of season. It's been a ride, you know. I owe a lot of people a lot of credit, starting with my offensive linemen and coaches, but I mean, this season's been like a dream come true for me.
People that, you know, are walk-ons, you know, you have to have a lot of confidence, and you gotta try to somehow gain the coach's respect, and yeah, that's probably the toughest thing, to beat out people that have money. They got scholarships and stuff, so, you know, they give them the first shots, and, you know, you realize that as a walk-on, but, you know, you gotta get past that, and you just gotta focus on your what you got to do, and you know, just be persistent. See, I came here like the summer before my freshman year, and I think it was the summer of 93, and I told them that I'd only be able to practice a couple days and then I was going to try out for basketball, because I didn't get a scholarship for football, so I wanted to see if I could do it for basketball right away, and the coaches were okay with that, and you know, basketball didn't turn out that well. And so I came out in spring, and I guess I gained a scholarship for football, and you know, I slowly creeped up the ladder, I guess, and it's been a long process, but here I am today.
Harry learned at a very young age in his life, well before he came to Eastern, how to handle adversity. His senior season at Olympia High School, he had really been incapacitated or debilitated by influenza and by mononucleosis, and had lost a bunch of weight. Consequently, no one really looked at him as a college basketball player. And his goal was to come to Eastern Washington, walk onto the basketball team, and really have a collegiate athletic career as a basketball player. And he wanted to play football, really kind of as an afterthought. And we allowed him to come on as a walk-on and play, and we watched him throw a little bit. And yeah, he can throw some ducks, and we need a guy to come in and relieve the really good quarterbacks in his class, who were the scouting quarterbacks at that time. Well, Harry played basketball. He didn't really get a fair shot to play, or he wasn't that good. He came out the next spring and really stood on the sidelines, and he shone a little bit in a couple of the spring scrimmages. Going into his sophomore season, he was the number 4 quarterback. And through a combination of injuries and poor play by the other quarterbacks, he was elevated to the number 2 position behind a fellow sophomore, Brian Sherrick. In the 6th game of the year in 1995, Sherrick was felled by an ACL injury, and Harry Leons, on his tuition scholarship, became the starting quarterback for a football team that was also sophomore dominated. And he struggled. He threw 5 interceptions in his first start. Through his last 3 ball games, I believe he threw an interception that was returned for a touchdown in each one of the 3 games. And he went through some growing pains, as was our entire football team at that same time.
Yeah, my first game here, I did throw 5 interceptions against Idaho State, and that was definitely a learning process. You know, there were some things during that game that I really didn't expect. It's a different level of football, and you know, it helped me prepare for the rest of the games since then. And you know, you really have to be prepared, and you got to watch a lot of film, and you got to study up on the opponent. And you know, without that, you really lost as a quarterback. So that helped me, actually.
Through the adversity, this humble and unassuming walk-on has become his team's leader.
I think absolutely the most pleasant surprise has been the efficiency with which Harry Leons has played quarterback. He has become the dominant player in this entire scenario. Not because he has a strong arm, or not because he's exceptionally fast, or it's the fact that he's able to make the correct decision when the defense presents itself. Playing offense versus defense, it's always a numbers game. It evolves into actually a mathematical matchup. And Harry's always able to find the advantage for the offense, because ultimately the offense dictates to the defense the tempo or the actual artistic part of the ball game. And Harry's really, he's been exceptional. He's been impeccable in his decision making and his ball handling, and he's been awesome in the way he's handled it through his own humility.
Since the coaches gave me an opportunity, I want to, you know, I think I owe him something, you know, and I've just been so happy, and, you know, anything I can return is just a bonus.
Leons going for extra yardage this time, and they'll pick it up with Ogden. Beats the tackle of Bell again, and this one's going to go. Bell hangs his head. Leons to Ogden, 77 yards, and the 10th touchdown catch of the year for Jeff Ogden.
Pretty much my main goal of playing football was just to hopefully get a scholarship and pay for my education. And I had some health problems with my back in high school, and just didn't turn out that any schools were going to give me a scholarship to play. So ended up going down to Clackamas Community College in Oregon and started pole vaulting down there.
We had some money available, and it was headed into spring practice. And his brother Pat, who had been a great player for us in the defensive secondary, came to me and said, "My brother's thinking about transferring from Clackamas Junior College, which is a non-football playing community college in Oregon, to Eastern to play football. He's interested in playing football." We had money available, and I said, "Hey, that'd be great, Augie. If he can be as good a player as you were, we'll take a look at him for one quarter."
It's definitely a challenge coming up. You know, you have your guys who are brought in and given scholarships, and the coaches tend to take a more in-depth look at them and how they play, obviously, because, you know, they're investing money and time into them. So it's kind of like we had to, you know, sneak out of the back of the crowd and try to be noticed and to do just about everything you could to be noticed. And so in that respect, it was very challenging, and but, I mean, that's good. I like challenges. I hadn't played receiver before I got here, so, I mean, just everything, the new position, the terminology. I came in during the spring, so the other receivers, they knew the plays and knew stuff like that, so I was pretty ignorant to the whole situation. So I spent a lot of time in my playbook and just thinking and just watching films and, you know, learning from the other receivers in front of me. And Coach Ray Williams, he's the receiver coach, and I think he came and started the year I came in also. And, you know, he played receiver in NFL and stuff, and he's just taught, you know, so many things. And I think maybe I was good person to work with, because I didn't have any habits formed before, because I never played. So he's really defined, you know, the way I play receiver.
He earned a starting position at the start of the 1995 season, but our trainers diagnosed him with having a bad back. In fact, he had a broken back, and the doctor said he could never play football again, and he missed the rest of the 95 season. Until it was discovered that his back injury was an old high school injury he'd received when he was pole vaulting. And if he'd gone this long, the doctor said, "Well, you might as well go ahead and go back to playing." Well, we opened up the season by moving the ball smartly down the field. We would get inside the 30, teams would blitz, Augie'd get one-on-one, Harry'd find him, touchdown. And you know, it hasn't let up. It's the same way. We, even against the great football teams, so the Montanas and the Northern Arizonas and the Idahos, Jeff gets one-on-one coverage. He's either running an inside route or an outside route, running an option off the route, and Harry's able to communicate with him because they're both fifth-year seniors, and they have an uncanny ability to make sure the pass is thrown to the right guy. An unlikely hero who also waited his turn, a lot like Harry, to become one of the dominant players in the Big Sky.
struggled through some tough times. They've stayed together as a staff. They went through a time when they had some young players, had to play them and take some lumps. And they were able to, you know, keep coaching and doing a great job with those people. You know, basically this is the same team that 3 years ago was got beat by 60 points by Montana and turned around and beat them this year for the conference championship. You know, they didn't give up. They kept coaching, doing the things that they knew that they had to do. And I think, you know, that's just a great credit to Mike and his coaching staff and to the players to stay together and continue to work and not disintegrate and look for easy ways of trying to get better, but know that the, you know, that it takes hard work and that's what it's all about. And, you know, this is just kind of the culmination of all of that. And obviously they did it the right way. And, you know, they're a very solid football team. Like I say, this could prove to be the best football team that's ever been here.